not the light.
So what if you're weirded out by the fire?
On May 2nd, 1946, the Battle of Alcatraz began. Two inmates, Bernard Coy and Marvin Hubbard, overpowered William Miller and locked him in one of the cells. Coy, who had been starving himself, was then able to force himself through the bars protecting the gun gallery and take command of the prison from within. By the time the failed escape attempt was resolved, 44 hours later, two guards and three prisoners were dead. The mess hall is where the staff and those prisoners not in solitary confinement would eat their meals. The ceiling was rigged with tear gas canisters, and the entry housed a metal detector. At the end of each 20-minute meal, all of the forks, spoons, and knives would be laid out on the table and carefully counted to ensure that none of the inmates had managed to smuggle away a potential weapon.
It's not like what JJ says. I'm not chicken shit.
I love it! Okay. You should join me sometime.
That should do it.
There's more footage than I thought there would be. This is going to take a while.
I can wait. I got one hell of a view.
Oh, shit. There's footage of the cops murdering people on the rock 5-6 times already.
Then I need to get out of here without alerting the murder patrol.
No time. Camera 11.
They're here? Shit. And that's gotta be Kestrel.
Get out of there, Marcus.
Nah, we need him. Alive.
He can verify the list of names we pulled.
The cops are already inside. There's no planning yourself out of this one.
Freestyle it is.
Thank you.
Suspect's description will confirm.
Officer involved collision.
911. State your emergency.
Suspect,
they're coming. He's wounded! Move it! Get down!
patents on technology in this department and a lot of potential for abuse. That's why you put me in with this crew, right? I can tell you straight away. Our guys using CTOS doesn't seem to be the core problem here. It's more that they don't follow through with solid police work on top of it. I can see it becoming a crutch. You'll get my next report soon.
Setting location on the 1033. Sending you a description of the suspect now.
911, please state your emergency.
Gracias. Yo me largo de aquí.
Stephen, keep your eyes on the suspect.
Units, sending you a description of the suspect now.
911, what's your line?
Suspect is using illegal ammunition.
Suspect's appearance was noted.
Sorry, Bob.
Gracias.
This is Big Yo Enough Vocal aquí. Squad. We have reports of a triggered alarm near your location. Please advise.
Stay close!
Suspect is showing signs of fatigue.
Suspect is on approach. Marine unit has been dispatched. Hey! Where'd he go? Check everywhere!
You know, is this thing working?
I hear you. You okay?
Yes. I am somewhere safe. Your friends gave me temporary access to this channel so I could thank you.
You can thank me by going public.
Count on it, my friend. Take it easy out there.
Yo, I am never going to Alcatraz again.
You got to live the dream, man! You escaped from the Rock?
That is 100% legit.
Okay, Dave, do you mind, man? Look.
Please?
I think I just want to sleep for like a year, if that's okay with you guys, all
Not
right?
Not yet.
Yo, come on. All right, fine, I'm up. Damn.
And voila.
Here with us now is City Councilor Miranda Kamei with her take on this latest blow to Oakland's foundering reputation.
Thank you, Shirley. But if it were not for the actions of public watchdogs and one very forthcoming eyewitness, we would not be having this conversation. It is my pleasure to announce that we have already launched a full-scale internal investigation with the a welcome.
Citizens of the digital age, welcome. Elements of the Oakland Police Department thought they could use predictive analytics to make Oakland safer. Instead, those who are corrupt hid in plain sight by perverting a feature designed to protect honest police officers from detection and retaliation. They smuggled drugs and organized hits. And they killed those who opposed them. Over and over and over. An official inquest into the OPD is underway, but the real culprit, Bloom's crime prediction algorithm, remains free of blame. Perhaps it is free of systemic bias, as its creators claim. Or perhaps it was able to be perverted because those filters, to single out the weak, the poor, the powerless, were already hard-coded. Without a release of their source code, we will never know for sure. DedSec is giving you the truth. Do what you will.
Look, look. Bigger picture moment here, okay? Let's all breathe in. Everything DedSec does supports our narrative, and breathe out. DedSec is a distraction, but they are our distraction. So let's hold on to that thought. Namaste.